No one's going to any planets right now because there are no vehicles that can take anybody to the planet. So all of these companies are trying to develop their own rockets, their own spacecraft, in order to take U.S. astronauts to the International Space Station. What NASA decided to do was to get out of the low Earth orbit business. How do you do that? You start turning over to commercial companies the flights to the International Space Station, taking crew, taking cargo, and eliminating the space shuttle program. It was the only way that NASA was going to be able to move out and do the things that NASA does best, which is to do deep space exploration. So now you have several commercial companies competing for contracts for taking cargo to the International Space Station, competing for contracts to ultimately take astronauts to the International Space Station. Now, some of these companies have been around a very, very long time, like United Launch Alliance, which is a group of well-established companies. Boeing, of course, we all know Boeing's been around a long, long time. And then you have other companies like Orbital, 1982. That's relatively new. You've got even newer companies like SpaceX, which didn't come into being until 2002. Companies like, you know, Blue Origin, other companies like Sierra Nevada. These are relatively new, young, upstart companies that are moving very quickly. The only place to go right now, until there are space hotels, until there are private space stations, is the International Space Station. So, you know, these companies really need NASA's money and NASA's seed money in order to develop their spacecraft. And at this point, the only real customer out there to go to the International Space Station, you know, is NASA. Now, Sir Richard Branson, he's going to fly individuals into low Earth orbit, just high enough to go weightless. That flight will last, you know, probably about an hour, and it'll cost you $200,000. SpaceX is saying that it can charge NASA $20 million a seat to fly astronauts to the International Space Station. Right now, because NASA has no way to get there but using the Russians and their Soyuz rocket, NASA is paying $50 to $60 million a seat to the Russians. So a big difference in how much it's going to cost if someone like SpaceX or Orbital, U.S. commercial companies, start flying astronauts, it'll bring the cost way down.